Hello， 大家好，我是 Stephen。 我在今年的一月份呢，就用 GTI 的这个申请方法，用了108日呢，就申请了这个澳洲的永居。如果大家想知道呢，这个 GTI 的 program 和这个澳洲永居的好处呢，大家可以留意我之前拍的那条片。正正就是因为这条片呢，有很多朋友就认识到原来有一个这么好的一个申请方法，而也都有知道不少的朋友呢，就开始了他们的申请。更加好開心咧，我就知道咧，我有幾個認識嘅朋友咧，佢哋已經收咗澳洲移民局嘅邀請 invitation， 咁意味著佢哋嘅申請咧，就應該好快就可以攞到呢個正式簽證。咁究竟 GTI Global Talent Independent 全球精英計劃呢一個門檻係咪好高？係咪好難申請到？其實我想講嘅就係我哋香港人其實已經好叻嘅，我認識嘅有唔少朋友咧，我相信都係可以滿足到佢嘅要求。但是入面大家要申请的时候，真的有很多细致的东西你们是要很清楚要知道。就是因为这个原因，我就今天就拍了这条片，请了我的移民顾问，就帮我成功申请到这个澳洲永居的移民顾问 Joanna Chan， 跟我们做一个简单的解释。如果大家有兴趣，又或者已经计划申请这个 GTI 的 program 呢，咁你就要留意呢條片嘅內容喎。
Okay, thank you, Stephen, for inviting me for this interview. So basically, my name is Joanna. So I have been specialized in Global Talent Independent Program. We have been helping quite a lot of candidates to obtain Australian permanent visa fast under the Global Talent Independent Program.
Hey, Joanna, as mentioned, many people, they are just looking to the official websites for the immigration program, but still there are a lot of unclear things to them. So,How do they do?
Okay, so the best way is always to seek professional advice in this area. I highly recommend them to ask advice for a registered migrant agent who specializes in this area. And you ask them advice, ask them to break down about the legal requirement. Now, majority of candidates, you know, they will see immigration website, they will have a look about this, they will say, okay, I'm not sure whether I'm good or I'm actually not good enough. As Stephen mentioned, that it's really important that, you know, you have information about this area. I actually have a YouTube channel. Okay, so in our YouTube, I actually upload quite a lot videos about this program, which really detail explain all aspects of the GTI program, as well as requirement plus the most recent change. So the reason for me to provide this information, just exactly what everybody thinks, it is that's limited information everywhere, that what is actual requirement. Everybody just go through these immigration website and they check through, global talent, they thought, oh my god, it's impossible, I don't meet the requirement. If you have this kind of understanding, that it's completely wrong. And if that migration agent saying, okay, you meet or you don't meet requirement, because look at that, look at immigration website, here we go, you don't meet requirement, they are absolutely wrong too. Because these people, as you know, migration agent, we should have access to legal library, we should have access to law. If we also know that a lot of agents down there, if they cannot provide you the legal requirement and their interpretation of the legal requirement, so in this case, I don't think they understand you at all. So I'm going to open up the legal one. I will show you a little bit. This is our Legend.com. It's our legal library. Now, if you approach anybody, you know, it doesn't matter who they are, you know, they claim who they are. You approach me, if I can't identify you in the requirement in the policy or the requirement in the policy, which means I perhaps do not understand the law at all. If I can't share this with you or I do not understand the requirement here, then you can't trust me, right? And if someone can't show you this, they cannot be trusted. So this particular requirement, for instance, people think now this, you have to have distinguished talent. They are referring this. They say, okay, I must answer the question, am I or am I not a distinguished talent? No, we don't need to say that. We don't need to claim it. We only need to say we meet many explanation of this definition. But By meeting requirement of their explanation, then we conclude ourselves, say, is this candidate disingenuous, right? Because this is the difference between a common language and legal law, you know, legal language. A common language can be changed if there's different culture. For instance, our understanding of talent is really different to a legal understanding of talent. If candidate go to the talent, global talent, immigration website, they read, oh, the global talent program also refer, we are looking for this one. Here, they thought this is actually referring to, I have to be a talented person. You have to have a substantial kind of achievement. You can't just be working as a professional, working in good companies, and you've done quite a lot of projects. That's not enough. You need to be a very talented person. But however, the immigration requirement is not looking for talented person, it's actually looking for global talent. So first one, it's you have to be, first one, you have to be a profession, right? Profession referring to a vacation requiring knowledge of some department of learning or science. So first of all, are we doing a profession? If yes, we tick the box. Okay, profession really referring to this kind of job requires some knowledge, some kind of knowledge of learning and science, which is formal education. As long as within a profession, we tick the box.
呢次嘅訪問咧，其實仲有好多好緊要嘅問題。咁啊，我哋喺後邊嗰條片，我哋會再繼續。